Hi, welcome to SexyMSRecipes.com. My name is Linda and I have multiple sclerosis. In fact, I've had it since 2008. Now, I haven't always felt this sexy. To be quite honest, I have felt downright dreadful, right up until I changed my diet. So this is all about fighting back, and I'm fighting back by eating my way out of it. And the first thing I went and did is I got some professional help. Yes, I did. Professional help in the way of a professional chef. Now, see, blondes do think. Now, Dallas is here to show us something sexy that we can eat that is all MS friendly. What are we making today?
Today, Linda, we're going to be making a honey dill salmon with roasted asparagus and some fingerling potatoes.
I love salmon, but I never know how to cook it.
Well, today we're going to show you a really simple way to do it. Oven needs to go on 375 degrees, and that temperature will work for cooking our asparagus, our salmon, and our potatoes. So the first thing we want to do is we want to get our potatoes going. Those are going to take in between 15 and 25 minutes, depending on your oven, depending on the potatoes. Today we're using a fingerling potato. Fingerlings are great. They have a buttery texture, a buttery flavor. If you can't find them at the grocery store, very similar to a finger.
Oh, well, I didn't even know they were called fingerlings.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, and if you can't find them at the grocery store, you can just use the regular new potatoes that they sell. Whenever I'm cooking with potatoes, I want to keep the skin on. So the thing is,
Why?
The outer layer of a potato has all the nutrients in it.
Okay.
So all those wonderful, you know, niacin, potassium, small amount of olive oil, and this is just gonna help them from not sticking to the pan. They're a starch. If you don't oil them up a little bit, they're gonna stick. Half a teaspoon of sea salt, some fresh cracked pepper. Give it a quick toss. We're gonna put those in the oven, and like I said earlier, 15 to 20 minutes. And while that's cooking, everything else in the recipe is gonna get done. We're gonna turn our pan on for our salmon to a medium heat. So while that's heating up, we're gonna get our asparagus ready. We're gonna take our nice, gorgeous BC salmon. Salmon has a great protein to fat ratio, and it's also a very complete protein. Full of unsaturated fats, so the good fats, good cholesterol, omega-3 fatty acids. As our pan's heating up, we want to use a small amount of olive oil. So just a little bit of salt and pepper. I'm going to put that into the pan and give it a really nice sear. It's going to seal in the juices and it's going to allow the salmon to keep its shape in the cooking process.
This is something you can order in restaurants, is the salmon, as long as it doesn't have a scary sauces on it, which we're about to learn, friendly sauce.
So we want to sear that for 2-3 minutes max.
Okay.
We don't want to be overcooking the salmon because we're going to put it in the oven to roast to finish it off.
Okay.
Ooh. At this time, we're going to take our asparagus, again, just a small amount of olive oil. So the salmon and the asparagus is going to take 6 to 7 minutes. Our fingerling potatoes have been in there for a little bit. We're going to give our salmon a really quick flip at this point. Oh, look at that. We're gonna take the heat off at that point. And this is gonna go directly in the oven. The salmon's in, the potatoes are going, the asparagus is gonna go in as well. So, while everything else is cooking, we're gonna turn our small saucepan onto very low heat. All we're doing with this sauce is bringing the ingredients together and warming it up so that it's not a cold sauce going onto the salmon when it's finished.
Okay.
So we're gonna start with a little bit of garlic, 2 cloves. So the garlic's gonna go into the pan. We have some grainy mustard. Mustard is one of those things, again, because you're on a restrictive diet, does not mean you have to have foods that don't taste like anything. Mustard is one of those things, it's very simple, it's vinegar and mustard seed. I like the grainy mustard simply because the whole seeds are still in it. And it gives a little bit of texture and a slightly different flavor. Because we have some vinegar, we're gonna contrast with a little bit of honey.
I love honey.
We have our sweetness, we have our little bit of heat from the mustard. We're gonna add a small amount of lemon juice. And then the last thing, some nice fresh dill. A little goes a long way with fresh herbs.
How do you keep fresh herbs in the fridge?
Best way to keep fresh herbs is some damp paper towel and a Ziploc bag with a couple holes in it. And that's gonna keep them fresh for, you know, up to a week. That's gonna go in. Little trick with ginger. Ginger is great It's great for your digestive system. Keep it frozen in the freezer. If you're not accustomed to using a fresh ginger, the best way to do it, you buy it at the grocery store, take it home, peel it into a Ziploc bag, into the freezer, and then if you have a wonderful little grater, it's a very quick, you can add a lot of flavor in a very short period of time, and then that can just go back in the freezer and be used for later. So as our sauce is coming together, we're gonna double check on the rest of our ingredients. You want a nice golden brown. So we're just gonna give it a quick toss here. Maybe flip it over, get a little bit more heat to the bottom side. So our sauce is ready. Our salmon is ready, beautiful, right? Salmon is one of those things, you wanna touch it, it should be firm with a little bit of give when it's nice and cooked. So that's gonna come out of the pan. Put that right out front and center because it's the star of the dish. And then our potatoes, just screaming to be let out. And the last thing to go on the plate is some perfectly cooked asparagus. I'm gonna spoon a little bit of our sauce. Just because you're cooking at home doesn't mean it can't look beautiful. And there you go, Linda, your honey dill salmon with asparagus and roasted fingerling potatoes.
Oh my God, oh my God. So you've got multiple sclerosis, you're gonna have this disease, you might as well live with it, and you might as well live with it sexy. Thank you, Dallas.
You're welcome.
We're gonna eat this now, and let's just eat it. Let's stop mucking around. Give me a fork.
There you go.
Oh, thank you. We'll see you next week.
See you soon.
Okay, which one are you gonna have?